Hi everyone, this is Brenda here. Welcome to my next episode, Day 30 of my Let's Clash series. So we have played this account for roughly a month, and we have progressed so much that we have reached to Town Hall 8. Of course, rushing our Town Hall, and a lot of you guys are complaining about it and saying good stuff about it too. So pretty sure I've show you guys how the way I play Clash, especially as to how I do my upgrades, how I manage my time, and how do I farm too. So I'm pretty sure some of you guys have learned a thing or two, especially in terms of increasing your farming rate, which I'm pretty sure has helped some of you guys improve the farming rate of your walls. So yeah, I've gotten like roughly 30 to 40% of my walls to level 8. So I'll be progressing to Town Hall 9 soon, maybe in the next episode or the next few episodes. I don't have plan for 8 right now, but we will see as how it go. As I just want to upgrade some of my army camps and also my clan castle and also some of my other stuff. So some of you guys have stated that I should upgrade my defenses a little bit, but still I'm not going to upgrade that because I'm not really too bothersome about it. But not to worry, I will upgrade my defenses more when I reach to Town Hall 9, also to get my 4th builder. Almost going to get my 4th builder soon, especially when I'm still pushing my way up to Crystal now at Gold 2. So I'll be trying to get to Crystal 3 as fast as possible so that I can get the 250 gems. And then once with the 1000 gem, I'll be able to get the 4th builder. So 4th builder, I'll be able to upgrade my stuff slightly faster, definitely. So I have to farm slightly more because the builders will be more free, as they'll be able to complete their tasks faster. And also I do have plans to upgrade my Dark Elixir storage soon. So I still have to focus a little bit on my storages, especially my elixir and also gold storages, because once I reach to Town Hall 9, I want to upgrade my walls a lot, and I'll be able to use both gold and elixir to upgrade the walls to level 9. So definitely having a higher capacity in terms of both resources, gold and elixir, will be a wise and idea to do. Not too much last time when I actually upgraded to Town Hall 9, it wasn't too important, whereas for now, because the walls are able to be upgraded with elixir, it's also essential to get the elixir storage to a higher level as possible, because with a higher elixir storage, I will be able to stock up more elixir when my builders they are upgrading stuff, and then once they are free, I will be able to use the gold and the elixir to upgrade the walls. So yeah, I'll be focusing on the storages and also my army camp and also my clan castle before I reach to Town Hall 9. Hopefully in that 10 days of upgrade time, I will be able to do a little bit of upgrade first too. So now going ahead to do a searching for a base to attack. So now as you can see, I do take quite a number of searches to find those kind of raids that you guys have been seeing. I know a lot of you guys have been asking how do I find such huge amount of loot. So it do takes a while to find it. I mean, I have to look out for it, and in terms of the timing and also the trophy range also do matter, as also mentioned in my BAM farming guide. So for those of you who haven't taken a look at my BAM farming guide in terms of how to farm the fastest with Barbarians, Archers and Minions, I'll put a link in the description below, which has always been in the description in all my Let's Clash series. So you guys can go and check it out and definitely learn a thing or two from it. So yeah, going ahead to do the search now. As you can see, I've not been able to search for any base so far, doing like roughly almost 20 over searches really. I mean, I usually go for those dead bases, or in fact those bases that I'm confident to go ahead to take the loot, and also those exposed town hall bases. So yeah, I'm still searching, so there ain't any bases for me to attack at this point of time. So we just have to just be patient and just keep searching. And of course those kind of raids whereby you see like 150,000, 160,000, you can't be too impatient or too greedy. You just have to wait and then see whether is it possible to search for 200 or 300 over 1,000 gold raid. So sometimes those 150,000 gold, if they are easy to get, like for example if they are all situated at one spot, like usually how I show you guys, yeah, you can go ahead with those. But if they're all spread out and all separated, as in the gold mines, or in fact half of it are inside the gold mines, half of it are inside the gold storages, then I don't see the point in going for it. So yeah, I also do look out for town hall snipes. I mean, this town hall isn't easy to snipe, but I decided to go for it because I do not want you guys to wait too long. So just going ahead to take out the town hall, and then we will be able to get more trophies. So the trophies will allow me to go one step or a few steps closer to Crystallic. So trying to get to Crystallic, as now this is my way of getting to Crystallic, which is sniping off Town Hall and also not losing my attacks whenever I go for a raid. So now trying to get a little bit of the gold, so I'll be able to upgrade one of the wall and then also do my upgrade so that my builder do not stop building, as now one of my builder is actually free. So I'm just trying to get a little bit of the gold, get a 500,000 gold and then have a little bit of gold left to do an upgrade. So yeah, we're just gonna lose this raid. Just getting 90,000 gold is not a lot, definitely, but it's just enough to go ahead with the upgrade. So going ahead with the upgrade right now, gonna upgrade my wall to level 8. And now with 124,000 gold left, I was slowly calculating my way. As I was planning to upgrade the elixir storage, so I was trying to slowly take my time and not rush through it. So just going ahead to spend the gold as slowly as possible. 49,000 gold left, upgrading one more gold wall, and then carrying on to upgrade a few more walls so that I can spend a little bit more gold, having as low as amount of gold as possible, so that whenever I go for defend later, I won't suffer huge loss. So now with 7,500 gold left, I did go and do a raid, and then eventually I found this 337,000 gold available base with the tower exposed on the outside left side, which is really awesome. So going ahead with the raid, taking out the gold mines, and then of course taking out the town hall too. The town hall has really been attacked by some of my troops on the left side, so going ahead to take and focus on the gold mines. Not gonna bother with the rest of the base. I mean, there's really no point to waste my troops on the other structures, even if the elixir is so much, but I'm not gonna get the elixir because there's really no point to me getting the elixir because my capacity is full right now. And also the dark elixir, I'm not too focused onto it right now because I'm not gonna upgrade any of my dark elixir troops, and also not gonna upgrade my heroes at this point of time. I'll be focusing more on dark elixir once I reach to Town Hall 9, mid Town Hall 9 to be exact. So for those of you who are eagerly waiting for me to show you guys some dark elixir raids, you guys have to be rather more patient about it, so that you guys can see and watch every single thing of how I farm my dark elixir and progress in the fastest way possible. Although it may not be the fastest way possible in terms of a clash fastest possible way, but it's to me the fastest way possible because I do farm for gold elixir and also dark elixir at the same time, so as to increase my walls and also upgrade them at the same time while I farm my heroes. And of course it do take a lot of effort to find the raids because at such a low trophy range it's not easy to find. But definitely when you go offline, it's not going to be very painful. If you guys are going to farm at Champion League, especially if you guys are like a Town Hall 9, I'm pretty sure you guys, the base will just get destroyed. Maybe even 80 or 90% or even 100% 3-star. So I mean, it's just going to be a juicy find for those pushers who are actually pushing for trophies. They will just see a Town Hall 9 and they just want to 3-star it. Because there are a lot of Town Hall 10s over there, and to find a Town Hall 9 at like Champion League is really like a bonus. So it's not really recommended in terms of for Town Hall 9 to be farming at Champions League. Maybe the highest I would think is like a low master, but not like a high master, like a master one. That would be totally dangerous for Town Hall 9. Especially if you want to stock up for loot, like for example if you want to upgrade an expo to level 3 or level 4, which requires a huge amount of gold, you will have to take quite a while to stock up. Then when you go offline, say when you have like a 400 million gold, you will lose so much gold that you will take quite a while to recuperate back your losses. And also it do take a while to search for raids, because the higher you are, the more difficult the bases are, the more difficult the bases are, the more skilled you have to be. And also with weaker troops, it's not easy to get those really strong and defended bases storages. So now going ahead to upgrade my Moda, gonna wait for it for 12 hours, and of course in the 12 hours gonna do some raids, doing some raids. But before that, I'm gonna go offline, and then when I went offline, somebody attacked me definitely. This guy using some giants, healers, and also barbarians and archers. So if you look at the top left, I only have like 12,000 gold available for him to loot, but he still insisted on attacking me. I think he was like kind of trophy pushing, but also at the same time maybe farming for elixir. Maybe he was trying to upgrade his walls or upgrade his army camp or whatsoever. So just going ahead to use some Hog Riders to attack me. I mean, hogging my base isn't too difficult because there ain't a high level giant bomb, that's one. And also my splash damage buildings ain't very high level, like my wizard towers and in fact my mortar also. So he's not really too worried about it, but he did a very nice job in terms of taking out my wizard tower, wizard in the clan castle, sorry. And then just going ahead to clear out my base with the remaining troops that he has, the barbarians and archers, and also the hawks. They just jump over the wall without even needing to break through the wall, so that's really a nice army to use. So I might try out using some hawks in clan war next time, maybe getting the hawks to like level 4 or level 5. I'm not too sure about that, but I'm not entirely a hawk player, but I will try it maybe. But I would prefer playing a lava lumians. Definitely, maybe going ahead to use that in clan war. As of now, I'm just focusing on Goblin Horde, golem wizard witch, and also my P.E.K.K.A. But the P.E.K.K.A. I won't be upgrading it. I will just let it stay at level 1. But once I've unlocked the witches and also the golem, I will definitely focus on them, trying to upgrade them to as high as level as possible. Getting the golem to like level 4 is really essential because their HP increases so much that they'll be able to take on more damage. And also the witches, getting them to level 2, they spawn more skeletons, so I do have to get them to higher level. So that's for Town Hall 9 planning, for those of you who are wondering what I have installed for Town Hall 9, focusing on those troops that I want to focus on for clan war especially. No, won't be using my heroes for clan war because I will be upgrading both of them simultaneously, and then they will be maybe the max level or level 30, then I'll start to use them. So we will see how. So yeah, going back with the raids, now as you can see, this raid has a lot of exposed buildings now on the left side, just my archer just taking out the gold mine. And I'm not gonna get the win for this because it's just gonna waste a lot of my troops because a lot of the gold mines still outside. And although the tower is outside at the bottom, I didn't want to go for it because I suspect that there are some Teslas and also some giant bombs maybe over there. So I didn't want to waste my troops trying to get the town hall. So now going ahead with the next attack on this town hall 7, definitely just focusing on the gold mines and taking a chance to try to get a 1 star out of it because a lot of structures have gone down. And definitely it's not going to be very difficult, not as difficult as just now that base that we just attacked, because that base was a town hall 8, having more structures to take down. And also at the same time, the defenses, they are much higher level than this town hall. And also taken into consideration that that layout was more difficult to budge than this layout. So definitely this is going to be a 1 star. Going to go ahead to try my luck. So going ahead with my wizards in my clan castle, not going to use my Barbarian King at all. Don't think he's needed for this 1 star 51%. And definitely going for the next attack. This next attack with just 165,000 gold available, but the gold mine, they're all outside, they're all looking very full. So just focusing my troops on the gold mine, just gonna sacrifice this as a loss. So for farming, in order to farm really intensively and also to increase your rate, a way to do it is not to win every single raid. You have to lose some and have to win some. So the way I do it is I will like usually win 3 and then lose 1. So when I win 3, I will get like maybe say 30 trophies. But when I lose 1, I minus 30 trophies, so it like kind of breaks even. So it's just a rough estimate, it's definitely not the exact amount of trophies. I mean, if I were to find a base that has 13 trophies available and then I win it 3 times, the amount of trophies I get is say roughly 12. But if I find a base that minus 33 trophies and I lose on it, definitely it's going to be a negative trophy for me. But yeah, that's just basically the average of winning 3 raids and losing 1. You can't go too high in trophies too. If you go too high, then you're gonna find and raid those kind of more difficult bases, and then your troops might not be able to get all the loot. So with that said, I also said that I want to get the crystal lake. So yeah, I've been pushing a bit. Of course, I don't want to use so much of my troops. I want to maintain my farming rate, not to decrease it so much by winning all the raids and then struggling to maybe even get like 48 or 49% to realize that I couldn't even win the raid. So you have to play smart and play intelligently, not just spamming your troops out. You have to have a keen eye of sense to see whether you are able to one star the base or not. I mean, I've been in situations whereby I do try my luck and risk it and just spam out my troops, and then eventually I get like 49% or 48%. Couldn't even one star, I waste all my troops, and then not even having any spells with me. I mean, it even happened on my main account. So sometimes you just have to be more vigilant to actually focus and see what kind of buildings are on the outside. So in order to get the percentage high, next time I will talk more about how to budge properly and also how to take note of what kind of buildings to attack when they are all exposed on the outside. Depending on the hit points of the structures too, I mean some structures that are easier to take out and some are more difficult to take out depending on the hit points of the buildings. Especially for those like the builder's hut and also the army camp, they are more easy to take out as compared to like the dark elixir drill, which has a rather high HP as compared to the other structures that I just mentioned. That's why usually when we budge, we try to focus on those kind of lower hit points buildings and to take them out. So now as you can see, this base has 233,000 gold available. Gonna focus on the gold as usual. The Barbarian King is gonna be on top trying to harass some of my troops, but not to worry, I'm pretty sure they'll be able to take him out. And now he has already gone down. And just going ahead to take out the rest of the other gold mines on the left side. Going ahead to drop my clan castle, which contains my wizards as usual. So I'm not too sure to switch around my troops right now, because in order to get the donations of one giant and also some wizards, it's not gonna be optimum as compared to just donating 5 wizards, because I can just use one account to donate to myself. If I were to donate say one giant and 3 wizards and then 3 more archers, I will have to either wait for 8, because I only able to donate up to 18 slots, and the 2 more archers I will either have to wait for someone to donate to me, or I have to wait for another 15 minutes to donate to myself. So maybe in the next upgrade of the clan castle reaching to 25 slots, and then I will be able to donate say 1 giant to myself and 5 wizards to myself, then I will be able to donate 6 troops. Especially when Mega Asia is actually a level 4 clan, so level 4 clan we are entitled to donate 6 troops, 6 type of troops. So it's really nice, so I can donate 1 giant to myself and 5 wizards to myself. So it's gonna be an easy task for me once I reach to 25 housing spaces. So yeah, I don't really want to trouble my clan mates to donate so much to me, because I've been requesting a lot. Like one day I do like roughly around 700 or 800 over requests of the troops. So it's gonna be kind of tiring and also kind of a resource taking from them to donate to me a lot of wizards. That's why I do not request and get wizards from them too often. But of course there are a lot of kind people in Mega Asia and also in SG Gladiators who have helped me a lot along the way for this whole entire Clash series. Ever since I started and wanted to get wizards in my clan castle, they have been giving me a lot of wizards definitely. So I really do thank them, my clan mates, for helping me out ever since the start. And also I would like to thank my good friend Doc Chen for lending me his account to use his wizards to donate to myself definitely. And of course I would have been able to do it with my main account. I mean, it's not going to be too troublesome for my main account, just knowing that I could just use his account to help him get a little bit more EXP and also at the same time help him waste a bit of his resources. So yeah, going ahead to do a little bit more of the upgrade now. As you can see, my walls, I'm just upgrading them and then just proceeding on to upgrade some of the archers, because I was just trying to calculate the time. Now we're going to upgrade my army camp to level 6, which will give me 5 more extra housing spaces, which is going to be a boost to my army strength, which now that's going to be the very last upgrade for this episode. So hope you guys have enjoyed this episode. I've gotten 79 level 8 wars. Previous episode was at 60, so I've gotten 19 level 8 wars for this episode just today. So I really farmed a lot for today. I think it was like kind of the most for this town hall level itself. So hopefully I'll be able to farm more in the next few days. Not too sure about that, but I'll be kind of busy for the next few days. Hopefully I'll be able to farm a little bit, maybe farming like around 8 to 10 wars in for the next maybe 5 days, because I have some personal matters to tend to. So with that said, I'd like to thank you guys for watching my video, and clash on.